make, or if he's just gonna say, you know, I'm just gonna play a catch-all build that does well against two of the matchups or something like that.
All right, well, we're gonna start on the top left-hand side where we've got our random player who is ruled as Protoss for game number one. It wouldn't be Europe without PvP. It is uThermal.
And his opponent in the bottom right-hand side, it is the blue Protoss player, PtitDrogo. And yeah, I mean, he's playing, I guess, PVC, which is kind of strange, right? Because PVC is not that good against PvP or PvT, you know what I'm saying? But in this case, I guess you can play like this. It's a middle ground in PvP, right? It's just not what I think of for Drogo usually. He's a little bit more standard than this. Like, you could see Max Specs doing something like this for sure.
Yeah, I think he's just sort of like rolling the dice, because two out of three times it's like, oh, you get Protoss or Terran. A Warlock's kind of fine against those races. Against Protoss, it's not as great, yeah. But like you say, it's not impossible. Drogo's going to say, I'm a bit more experienced in the matchup, and that should let me make up for it if I do roll this disadvantage based on my initial building choice. So I think this is just a game of odds from Drogo and just saying, well, where do I take an advantage? What is the worst case scenario? He rolls Protoss against me, okay. Am I comfortable enough in PvP playing the low ground gateway? Yeah, probably, because surely I have way more PvP experience than he has.
Surely. I mean, that is very valid. That is a very valid approach I hadn't fully considered, right? Like, he could have actually thought this through to where he's like, okay, like, I'm gonna... But then why is... I mean, it's still kind of sketch against Terran, which I imagine is still uThermal's best, right? Or... I don't really know what his shape is like. Yeah. Maybe Zerg is scarier.
I mean, you can still play it. It's, like, risky against, like, certain proxies and stuff, but I guess it's kind of fine against the majority builds. A lot of the time, you want to wall off at some point in case of, like, Hellion run by and so on, so it can be punished, but I think the Terran has to do very certain things to punish it, which isn't a guarantee either.
Okay. We see Drogo here looking for a little bit of a block, a little bit of a slowdown onto uThermal's expansion. uThermal already has a sentry.
Yep.
Yeah,
we're going to get to see some of them new sentries, and the fact uThermal is looking to basically just expand kind of gives me a little bit of excitement, Cats, because, you know, we weren't necessarily guaranteed this, and it shows that uThermal is kind of happy to play the two base versus two base Protoss rather than just being like, oh, cool, you've got a low ground gateway, that means I can go and try and kill you. And we kind of see that kind of older, kind of, you know, aggressive PvP style. So I think a lot of people might have expected that, but nope, we're going to kind of match Drogo on the expansion. I'm going to see uThermal choosing to go into that robotics facility. Meanwhile, Drogo is Twilight Counseling it up. So that is our difference in setups for the moment.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, what do you think are the chances here for Mark now that we have hit the PvP? Because I think before the series, maybe I thought of this as a 50-50 or so, just in my mind. But now that we've hit the first PvP and it's kind of like this standard macro game where Mark isn't really looking to do anything too crazy or to, you know, like to surprise his opponents all that much for the time being. Do you highly favor Drogo now or you think we're chilling?
I think we should. But then I'm like, if uThermal's comfortable to do this, clearly he doesn't... You know what I mean? Like, he doesn't...
Think so.
Yeah, because he had the opportunity, right? It was the perfect chance to be like, oh, cool.
Yeah.
Low ground gateway PvP. So if he didn't want to play the macro game, he had his out already. So that kind of makes me maybe feel better for uThermal than I would have when he first spawned in. So it's kind of weird.
I love that, yeah.
Yeah, I kind of believe in his own belief, I guess.
Yeah, I can see that. All right, he's going to be lagging for the time being just the five workers behind. He did load up four sentries in the warp prism, though. So this he's trying to make a YouTube video out of this as well. And I imagine if he can get behind that mineral line, I mean, the four sentries will pretty much destroy the shields very fast. Yeah, and you can trap them, right, with enough force shields.
Yeah,
so.
That's actually kind of a sick idea, man. If this works, I'm going to love it, so... I'm already on board, Cats. Show me the way. As yeah, this could actually be pretty devastating for these probes. They're gonna have to pull quickly if they do want to pull away. There's nothing in the back of this base.
They
here we go,
man. This is tough. I mean, everything's gonna get trapped here. At least all of those probes now are basically. Oh, what a beautiful recall from Drogo! Quick reaction time as well. So that's not too bad. Only six workers have fallen so far. Don't give him any more. You don't want to walk back in there. And he is walking back in there, but he has Blink. So that is going to be really nice. Actually works as a bait. And the recoil is there for uThermal. I'm not even sure how he recoiled and still dropping. Oh, no, that was Drogo's force shields. A little bit weird to waste the energy instead. But yeah, I mean, that works out really well for uThermal.
Yeah, that was actually really good. That was so strange. Obviously, Drogo's taking a third base, which now uThermal's going to try and punish. Just,
wow.
Yeah, just going to move on the map and try and send it. The only thing lacking really right now is the Prism. If he still had a Prism already, right?
Oh, my.
That would have been amazing, but obviously not quite meant to be.
Shaking.
And he is going to expand behind this, but so tough, I still like his pressure, man. I still like the pressure he can apply.
Yeah, I mean, I love his pressure, in fact, right? Like, if he only had a War Prism still around, I feel like this would be pretty much game over. As it stands, though, without the War Prism, he's still in a decent position to apply some pressure. It's those force shields that have done wonders for Drogo on defense, but he only has a couple left now.
Yeah, a couple left over, so maybe we won't see too many more of him, which is a good thing for uThermal, because it's definitely stopping him from being able to move through in any sort of further way. Stalkers, sentries, and a couple of mortals continue to move about over around the left, and the forge and a couple of gates coming up as well.
Yeah, the War Prism's being remade, but it wasn't there for that attack, sadly. And I feel like uThermal still had an opportunity there, maybe, and he is lagging behind probes, so maybe it would have been good to do something or try to do something more with that army advantage. If he could have had the presence of mind of remaking that that War Prism for this push, it looked like a really strong push, right?
Yeah. No, I'm with you, man. Because also, as well, the force fields are so much less effective when there's a Prism in play. They can buy you time, but they can never get your units trapped and killed because the Prism just evacuates. So it gives you so much more confidence to move forwards and aggressively poke in than what he would have had, you know, just there. You already saw a couple Stalkers having to go run a rear direction trying to get out of force fields. So definitely feel like that's a bit of the factor as well. Cool one, though.
Yeah, I mean, he's still okay, though. Blink is about to finish. He has these four sentries going back in. So, I mean, I love it. I hope it works again. Four Stalkers on the other side are trying to do what they can to make things annoying, to make the fourth difficult to take for Drogo, and actually now going into the main for Stalkers to one-shot a probe, and also two-shot apparently a Stalker as well, as now uThermal is in position. So are the sentries. Wardicio, how many will be killed here?
Bro, I don't even want to make a guess because I feel like I'm going to be so wrong. Like, if I say really a high cool. number, I'm going to be ridiculous, but if I say a low number, I think I'm actually going to be wrong. He gets 9 worker kills. What are we witnessing? Yeah.
I mean, that was also for minimum energy spent,
yeah.
Right?
It's two not force like fields, he used all.
Yeah, that was very nice. That was nine probes just off of two force fields, exactly, and saves everything in time as well. He didn't overstay his welcome or anything like that. He could have gotten easily 16 probes at the risk of maybe losing some or all of that. But he gets 9 safe, and that's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good job is just going to be seen now. Plus 2 in charge finishing now from Drogo. So you will have that on the side as well. And that roll in here. And just have our units going through and up the left-hand side of the map. So a little bit of a journey. Stalkers running into each other.
Indeed.
Prism comes back in, man. God, how many times do we see this Prism show up?
Yeah, way too many. And now, I mean, there's the trap onto the probes yet again. Another Stalker's gonna fall. The force fields continue to be good. More warpins on that side. On the other side, I mean, the immortals are there. The problem are gonna be the zealots, and there is a couple of really good force fields from Drogo that's gonna isolate at least one of those immortals. It could have maybe been two. The blink forward is questionable, perhaps onto a cannon and the fortified location or position from one of those immortals. And again, uThermal's doing wonders on the other side, Wardicio. So I feel like Drogo has to look for a kill move, and that blink was just not it.
No, this was not it at all. Just yet so far, we are going to be seeing uThermal protecting himself and keeping himself very much so alive right now. So looking to stay in a pretty respectable position here, and honestly, it's going to make this happen.
Good.
He is down in upgrade cats, which may affect him to some extent at some point, but he's also going to get the armor upgrade, so that's at least something that helps. He's now winning the fight over here as well. These Stalkers going down. Can he actually protect this Nexus? He actually might. He will.
Could, I mean,
Oh my god.
That is ridiculous. That is ridiculous because that's up to Drogo. But of course, Drogo is preoccupied watching what's going on in his main because he really just needed to shift the attention of one or two units or you know, at any point, all of his army to at least get that Nexus on the way out. As it stands, somehow, some way, this is still an even game in terms of supply, which is just mind-boggling. What is going on? I mean, such a crazy game.
Yep. Looks like uThermal's lagging as well. Man, yeah, what a crazy game, because this is going to kind of equalize. Drogo has more workers, uThermal has more army supply. Feels though, generally, though, looking at this, I mean, I like it more for uThermal. He's got more Stalkers on the map, and that's a big deal, because Stalkers are a bit more expensive to replace than Zealots. So, in terms of standing army, uThermal's army is just more valuable as well.
This is true. Like, yeah, there's a little bit more gas there, a little bit more potential for retention. Drogo feels hard-pressed to try to make something happen here and try to kill the fourth of uThermal. uThermal better be paying attention so that he can punish. This Nexus cannot be saved, but the army of Drogo could potentially be punished. However, with this warping of Zealots, it's starting to look really, really good for the Frenchman.
Yep. No,
no,
he is
no
get,
battery, right?
What's yeah, really... he gets rid of the Nexus, which is obviously a big deal, and now he's just going to keep coming through. The Zealot numbers are huge. I thought uThermal might be able to match him to some extent in Zealots, but he's just been focused on Stalkers. He's going to pull back now to where he does have a battery. This is potentially where the fight could turn around for him, but he just needs something to start tanking against the Zealots, man. Really needs it.
Yeah. Yeah, that's unfortunate. I mean, uThermal, it really looked like he had it for some portions of this game. Some really cool tactics as well. But Drogo smells blood in the water. He knows what to do. And if he doesn't get answered, then he's going to continue to push on forward. And unfortunately, a little bit of lag here.
Yep.
Was that me?
No, I saw this one as well. This too, so I don't know what's up this time. Is yeah, this time uThermal's gonna say GG. Okay, he's gonna say GG. It's a little bit of an awkward ending, but Drogo does clean up and he does finish it out. Drogo takes game number one of this best of three. So Drogo with the 1-0 lead, and man, he lost 15 brokers to sentry drops. Still turns it around. I honestly really felt uThermal had it there for a couple of moments, man. Like, I thought we were witnessing something. It was kind of wild.
No, for sure. For sure, it looked like he had it, to be honest. It was just an issue of I think... I'm not even sure what happened there. I think if he made a battery at the fourth, I mean, towards the tail end, but even before that, it felt like at some points, you know, he had the much better end of the trades. So I'm not sure at which point it went so wrong to get us to a position where Drogo, you know, was in a killing position. Obviously, like, at that point, I think a shield battery would have gone a long way because you have Stalkers, right? So the Nexus tanking against the Zealots is how you output enough DPS to actually win those fights. And you have a Blink, so you can retain it. And you like structures in front of you, right? So if your structure has 10% of the HP that it could have if it had regenerated all of its shields, then it's not going to be too helpful and you get to engaging right away and now you're in the open and... there's no battery overcharge, right? So I feel like a battery or two would have gone a long way there. But before then, even, it felt like in that trade where he's with the sentries and warping in his main and defending Drogo at the same time, that really felt like uThermal had it right there and then, and I'm not sure what happened.
Yep, absolutely. So we got ourselves ready to go into this next one. We just wait for our... players to join. I think uThermal's just taking a moment, maybe because of internet stuff, so we will work on that and we'll get that sorted out next couple of moments. Get that underway.
What are you hoping he gets? Are you hoping for Terran? Are you hoping for Zerg?
No, I honestly think...
Are you hoping for another?
I think Zerg's is worst, so I'm kind of hoping Protoss or Terran. I actually would love to see another PvP, honestly, after game one.
That would be cool.
I mean, more sentry drops killing probes. I'm all about that, Gats. What a great consequence of the patch. Who knew the patch would lead to this?
Yeah, and in particular in that matchup, right? So that's very interesting as well, that it's not something that's as replicable for the other matchups. Though I don't think it's like, you know, like the worst thing in the world against Zerg, maybe. But yeah, I mean, certainly against Protoss. Much faster work off those probes with extra damage to shields. Side Delta will be the map for this one, Wardichio.
This map's going to be better for... This map's going to be better for Drogo's plan in terms of its initial opening.
uThermal's getting... But what is uThermal getting? Race, guess. Too late.
No, I wanted.
It's a PvP. Your wish granted.
Bro, I told you I wanted to see the PvP. That's basically my guess.
You did want it. Yeah,
that is get it. Your it's also Europe. You're basically obliged to roll Protoss in a PvP.
Yeah.
All right.
Now, okay, we can do intros right now. But I have a theory. If you're uThermal at this point, do you anticipate that Drogo will low ground gateway, and do you look to punish it blind?
Yeah, but this is what I was going to say about the map, because this map has a ramp, right? So it's going to be difficult to punish that.
I see.
Yeah, so the defense is there, so it's actually a good map to play versus random on, because you can really cover all bases. There's not really as much of a punish, so yeah.
Yeah, and Drogo does scout right away for proxies, so anticipating that maybe, uThermal could have gone for some sort of a punish, or... You know, like there could be, but he could find barracks or gateways, I guess, out here. And from his perspective, it's an interesting scout to say the least. uThermal's gonna do a normal scout instead, and the probes will meet in the middle of the map or near it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's have ourselves there. Gates coming up, the assimilator's coming through. Probe on each side as we get a couple of gateways coming down as well, so we get that on the way. And we just wait for. Setup. Obviously, uThermal is going to high ground. I mean, uThermal knows his PvP, so he's still going to go those high ground double gates. And Drogo will double gate himself, so he's just going to play low ground double gates. That's going to take away a lot of aggressive opportunities uThermal might have had.
Yeah, for sure. And at the same time, uThermal will be fully aware of what's going on, so maybe he doesn't mind too much. Is there something maybe that he can do to delay the expansion of Drogo on the other side, block the Nexus with the pylon or something like that? That would be nice.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, anything to slow down the expand if you're going to expand yourself, right, could be cool. I was going to see our Sentry and Stalker coming up.
Yeah, might be seeing a mirror here. It will be Sentry Stalker against Sentry Stalker. 23 workers of Drogo to 24 of uThermal, now equalized, so things are very, very mirrored. Both players are going to block each other's expansions. This is a standard PvP war, Dicho.
Standard PvP. No, it really is. Obviously, one guy goes low ground gates, but other than that, yeah. Pretty much the same situation. No one's going to try and punish those low ground setups or anything, so it should just be kind of fine across the board.
Do you like, at this point, having the gateways there better, or do you like it less? Like, which setup would you rather have?
I guess at this point, I'd actually kind of prefer the high ground, right? Because now there's nothing that's going to be aggressively coming towards you that you need the low ground to help you defend against. Like, you need the wall to help you defend, so then it's just more likely that wall off loses you a gateway or something, you know? So there's certain builds where it's like the wall helps you buy you a lot of time, but the way that this game is going... It's just not necessary. So then it's just a liability. It's going to be more difficult to move out of your natural. So, yeah.
Yep. All fair points. I'm with you there. I like the open space at this point, too. And now both players are going to be experiencing a little bit of a deviation in terms of tech, as uThermal will be going for the quicker Twilight Council. So what do you make of this, Wardichu? What are we going, just the classic blink? And what's up with the Robo's? How do you use the Robo if you're PtitDrogo? Do you want to take a faster third, perhaps, and just look to defend?
Yeah, I guess he's also a bit unsure. So he's like, if I go Robo, I'm very unlikely to die because I will just have Immortals. It will keep me very safe. It will keep me in a very good position. So I can only imagine that is kind of part of the idea right now. And that's a big part of the kind of steps we take to kind of continue through.
Ooh.
I see uThermal is going to go for the Dark Shrine. I guess the robot would keep you safe against stuff like that as well if you get the Observer out, but of course that still requires you to get the Obs out.
Yeah, for sure, but it's a nice move for sure from uThermal, as that Adept is going to barely survive. I'm not even sure how that happened. And now there's a move out, and very smart from uThermal not to run towards the choke where he would inevitably die to force fields. Instead, he runs back, and now if he wants this extra stalker, it's going to cost a little bit more. In fact, there's no energy for two force fields, so it will have to be let go of. But yeah, great anticipation from uThermal, right? Very unintuitive to turn around and run towards your opponent, but it was very much the right choice.
Mm-hmm. Do you see these depths? Gonna shade up. Stalkers, sentries holding out on that ramp. Dark Shrine still coming online. Probes are building across the board. Nexus is still on up, and PtitDrogo is the Immortal and the Adept. We'll get into a little bit of an altercation. This one Adept, though, from Drogo is actually going to come through for good for you. Probe's going to get three workers. That is nice. I mean, this is really going to come down to that Dark Shrine, and again, there's not an Obs on the map just yet, so we are about to pop off for uThermal, I think.
I think so, and he's warping in two DTs outside of range. Drogo is doing a uThermal onto uThermal here. As he drops a couple of sentries worth, will kill 10 probes for his troubles. It's all up to the DTs right now. Don't listen to the supply. It's so important to note that there is indeed no observer out. And Drogo hasn't scouted anything in the main of uThermal that tells him there's DTs coming, and here they are. So now starting to rack up are going to be kills on either side. Chrono Booster is the observer of Drogo. And can uThermal find the pylon and depower the Robo? Because that would just be game ending. It doesn't look like he's trying.
Yep. It's going to be seen DT continue to move about a little bit. Just going to be seeing that DT goes down. 14 probes going down is brutal. That's only going to equalize the work account, though, and Drogo has a much faster third. Unfortunately, that third base also under attack from DTs. This really has been a major problem. This Dark Shrine has worked beautifully for uThermal. He is getting so much done from the Dark Templar, and that is a huge changing point of this game. Drogo has a larger army, but how do you get across the map to use it at this stage? That is a great question.
That is a great question, worthy Chong. It looks like he's just gonna use one immortal for the time being, and that guy is chunky, so uThermal's gonna have to bring an immortal of his own to try to dislodge. The Drogo turns around to snipe one stalker on the way out very beautifully, and War Prism is gonna be tagged as well for information. And now uThermal sees, oh my god, I'm leading him to my Dark Shrine, I'm just gonna go somewhere else. Instead drives towards him. But yeah, when all is said and done, I mean, it's even worker counts and similar supplies, similar tech. So things are looking maybe just better, looking a little bit better for Drogo because he's the more experienced player, I feel like. But other than that, it's an open game.
Yeah, Sentry Stalker is going to put a bit of damage out. We do have our Prism back into the center. uThermal is... Again, still lacking on army, and Drogo does seem to move forwards here a little bit. That Prism's gonna fly by, though, and keep him distracted, it would seem. Just gonna have a hallucination.
Yeah, a little bit
find
of a pull
way.
There. Yeah. Couple of immortals and three sentries now making their way onto the middle of, the third base of uThermal, which he wants to try to defend.
Yeah.
It's a mirror here. Archons are nice, I guess, right?
Yeah, Archons are great, especially because Drogo's about to hit Zealots, right? So Archons are actually a very important part of this. You need to have some splash to clean out your opponent's Zealot frontline, and that's what we're starting to move towards.
And that's really nice, because that's just off of the investment. It's further payoff from the investment of those DTs that were already so useful, right? Like the ability to make Archons, your opponent isn't there. He does have two Adepts, however, in your middle line, and that's going to cost you at least three probes for the time being if you're uThermal. The Adepts will also continue to shade in and try to make it into the main to cause further trouble. And great force heals to start off from Drogo there as, or from uThermal there as Drogo's forced to pick up and turn around. Depowered are going to be two of those gateways as well. And uThermal with a very, very good engagement on the other side of the map. Three or seven probes have fallen on his side and it kind of stopped there. So he dealt with that fine as well. Shield battery overcharge is popped, but no fear on the side of uThermal as he continues to move on forward and focus fire units with his immortals, completely ignoring the battery overcharge for now. Gets rid of it, and he's doing it, Wardicho.
He is doing it. Four immortals are just so powerful right now, and there's no buffer. So his opponent's immortals have to keep hitting the Zealots, and because they have to keep hitting the Zealots, it's just a waste of time. The Zealots get canceled. Now the probes are going to pull. That might be the best thing that could happen here for Drogo. The probes can tank a lot of damage, but uThermal's going to get a warp in his Zealots as well. Microing in the Prism. uThermal is a top-tier micro player. We knew this from his time as a Terran professional, and that is being shown right here as well. Micro was spot on. These immortals are going to recall to death, and that is going to be uThermal to close this one out because Drogo is down to 50 supply or so. He does not have enough.
He does not have enough, and yeah, I mean, this is some emotional damage as well. If you think about it from the perspective of Drogo, I mean, this is a classic, right? uThermal versus Drogo. These are two storied players that have had very, very high peaks as far as the European region is concerned, and they've always been kind of competing with each other at different parts of their careers and different peaks in their careers, but they've always been around each other, so you know, to lose to lose to someone playing your race and that you've, you know, thought of as sort of an equal for so long, it's painful, Guardicho.
No, it's brutal as
feelings are being had right now. Yeah.
Yeah. No, that is well, that is true. Is that temple out guy's about to come up here from Drogo? We all gonna push up. Couple of these gates. Tony Caps, these gates are a liability. They're gonna buy you about two seconds now. Cold. Now you're gonna lose your gateways and well, uThermal, he's got a drop to deal with on the other side, but he has just got an force that cannot be stopped back on Drogo's side of the map, so can only imagine that this is gonna come through to victory.
Yep, it looks very, very good here. I mean, it's a nice setup as far as a concave is concerned for Drogo. Here comes the world prism a little bit late actually on the side of uThermal. So he is forced to disengage for just a second, but I mean, Drogo didn't manage to do enough to mitigate for the fact that his opponent is on three base, now taking a fourth on the other side. So uThermal can play this as patiently as he wants. 70 workers to the 38 as well is going to make it near impossible for Drogo to ever catch up on economic fronts. And as far as the army supply is concerned, he's also behind. So, like, you know, like, what can you do? It's
nothing,
tough.
Nothing really. This really is just kind of done. uThermal's just going to work on some upgrades and just trying to secure his position. Obviously, taking extra base. He is taking a fourth while Drogo takes a third. So, there's no problem with uThermal just stopping, slowing, and just taking a moment. You know, this is absolutely fine for him. 100% something he can get away with here, and that's exactly what he's going for. There's a couple of DTs warping on the side of uThermal, and just going to be obviously able to use those still to harass with if he wants to. So, again, every option is there for uThermal, but it just doesn't exist for Drogo.
Yeah, I mean, he is trying to carve himself an advantage little by little, right? Like, start chiseling away with a couple of immortals. Those can one-shot probes if they ever choose to, but instead they're going to go after the shield battery. And on the other side, there's a little bit of a cellar contingency that also gets dealt with. And the main, Drogo started to breach through. And oh my god, can you imagine a comeback here and the emotions that would be had? That would be insane. But it's a little unlikely still.
Yep, and there's a couple of zealots that's going to go through. Pylon's going to be taking some damage. The immortals firing back, going to get a couple more cleanups. The uThermal defense is going to be there. Okay, it cost you a few probes, but you're still up by 20. Doubling the army supply almost as well. That prism will take a shot or two. It's going to run out of options of what it can do. As we have the blink starting up from uThermal. And, well, not starting up, but waiting to be resumed once the pylons get rebuilt. So get that all repowered again, and we'll be back on track. And again, uThermal just going to sit here and, okay, nice bit of damage from Drogo, but he needs so much more than that.
Yeah, but DTs, I mean, if there was ever a unit to make so much more than that happen, it could be the Dark Templar. I mean, there is an observer now that will spot Drogo's observer. So Drogo knows that uThermal has an observer. There are now two cannons going down in the main. There's one in the fourth. There's one in the natural. Okay, maybe there's no. I mean, there's no cannon in the third triangle.
No, is uThermal going to find this army here? And Drogo just says, nuh-uh, ain't happening. GG's, uThermal gets to 1-1 in what has been a PvP so far. And that is meaning that we are going to get to our first game three here between these two. I was going to say first game three of the day, but that's obviously not true. Goblin and Heroine went to game three. So another game three for us is going to be coming up in just a second. We wait to see what the map will be. And obviously, again, we don't know what matchup it's going to be because uThermal's playing random. He could spawn in as anything.
Yeah, he could spawn in as anything. I mean, it's Dynasty is going to be the map as well. I mean, on that map, crazy things happen. I am betting on Protoss three times in a row at this point. What do you think?
Yeah.
Or are you the type of guy that would be like, we just got Protoss twice in a row. We got to, that's, you know.
Cats.
The gambler's fallacy. Do you subscribe to the gambler's fallacy?
I know fine well anything is possible right now. So I'd say Protoss because I think Protoss is more likely because we're more likely to believe in it happening because it's already happened.
Wow. Okay. So, you know, so you think that if we activate a collective belief in that Protoss will be the race that we get? Against all odds, we will get Protoss three times in a row and three PvPs in a row.
Yeah.
And then uThermal wins. That's the magical touch, right? Like if we all, could we all sink together in that wish?
Yeah, pretty much. That's it, Cats. That's how I'm believing it.
I believe. Okay, let's go for it then. Protoss, PvP.
I do think the worst thing that can happen for uThermal is to spawn in a Zerg. Because I think A, Drogo's good PvZ, and B, this is not a great cheesy map either.
Now you're, Now you're bringing forth the bad thoughts onto the people, vibes. No?
Yeah.
The bad vibes. Now you're setting us up for a CVP.
Well,
but imagine if it was a CVP and uThermal takes it with his worst race.
Well, then I'd be in jail.
The emotional damage.
Emotional damage.
Oh my god. Well, we're about to find out.
Good thing Drogo has until next week to play again.
This is tough.
We are counting down. We are heading into game. It's Dynasty for the map, by the way. So heading into
this
right now.
What an interesting map as well. Yep. I mean, the natural is a gold, right? Like the random advantage grows a little bit here in that sense. You can't as easily decide against random, I'm going to drop my gold, right? But as random, you kind of know what you're going up against. And it will be a Terran game, Guardicio. It is uThermal's bread and butter.
His bread and butter.
The top right-hand side. Bread and butter. Tough.
Yeah, that's what's in the top right. Bread and butter, guys. In the bottom left. PtitDrogo. We have one SCV on the map early here. And of course, this could be looking to take advantage of the fact that Drogo doesn't know what matchup it is. So a proxy can be that much more impactful from the very get-go.
That would be very true. And I mean, that's exactly what he's going for. That's sad for Drogo because he actually looked for this exact thing potentially happening in the last game, right? So he might yet still. He is moving out with a probe, but it looks
downwards.
But he's looking around. He's clicking with purpose, right? He didn't just click on the other side of the map. So unfortunately, he's moving too far out now, right? Like this is not where the proxy is. So yeah, he's just going to cross and see what's going on. Too far gone. And now that he's going to scout that the barracks is not at the top, he will then realize it is a proxy and then look to adapt to it. But the proxy is out there. He doesn't know where.
Needs to figure that one out as we do have the probe moving into the upper right side. So again, a little bit of a scout around. Obviously going to notice that there's nothing here. So yeah, it's now a little bit more knowledgeable.
Nothing but the gas, right?
Yep.
Yeah, but there's going to be a factory out there as well, is what he has to start preempting. And I guess you could drop the factory as well defensively if you're uThermal, but
maybe less likely. Yeah, I mean, now that you see the SCV, you're going to assume it's not the factory on the map because it would be building the factory still. So there's actually just information gained there for Drogo already. So yeah, he gets that bit of information as the SCV shows up. Should be pretty fine with that. And this bunker just going to block for a little bit and just kind of make life a little bit complicated.
Just a little bit. The first Reaper is right here already. I mean, he is very fast to it, but there is a Zealot out. It can be ignored in favor of going after the probes. So maybe we can still get a couple of probe kills here from uThermal. Beautiful probe pull, however, from Drogo to prevent the Reaper from taking its preferred path.
Yep.
Stalker's now out. Nothing gained from this.
Nothing gained at all, and Reaper is going to drop a grenade to help him get away. And that is just going to give him the ability to turn that corner more easily. So, getting out of there, nice and easy. Because the shell's on the way up, by the way, so this proxy is still alive and it's still been working. Now on the way to those marauders, so doing something a little different here. Because the shell's coming up as well, and that Reaper coming back up into the main.
Yeah, very annoying indeed with the extra pathway that it has to travel on this map. It's kind of difficult for the Protoss to spread themselves that thin. And now a Hellion as well. So uThermal is really trying to create as much chaos as possible on the other side of things. The Marauders with concussive shells as well could add a lot. They could catch a Stalker. The further out Drogo chases, the more likely he is to lose a key unit and potentially snowball into Oblivion, as the Marauders will catch the Zealot. That guy is not going back home.
Nope. Not going back at all. He's just going to be keeping some pressure up. He's going to be seeing the couple of Marauders trying to put some damage in, and they are going to try and come through there nice and quickly. So, putting some damage out. Full work is already going down, and Drogo going to lose a potentially low ground pylon. We're actually going to move up this ramp because uThermal realizes, hey, there's a battery I can get rid of here already. Remember, this is concussive shells. Oh my god, the probes are stacked!
What?
Oh. What? Didn't even get that.
The
Hellions do splash.
Right move against Hellions. I'm not sure what happened just now. Oh my god, what just happened now?
Oh my
that
goodness,
is what
cats.
That is the thing that you don't want to do, guys, against the Hellion unit.
Did he? I just don't understand. What was he thinking?
I do not understand. Like, I'm taking time to compute right now because I really don't want to be like, yeah. You know, like maybe someone out there is like, no, that made sense.
Oh, please show me how. Yeah, well, I'd love to know.
That was wild. I mean, that was insane.
I understand that he maybe needs the probes to help fight, perhaps, but...
For sure.
To do
just
it the way
like
he
this.
Did? Yeah, exactly, right? Like, not like this. Because now the Ascendry's in trouble, too, because the Stalker's just lost the fight to the Marauder Micro. The Force Field honestly wasn't even that spot on. A third Marauder showing up, another probe is going to spawn into death, and uThermal's got this completely under control, Cats. GG, uThermal is going to take the victory over Drogo.